Bismillah walhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam wa la rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullaha haqqa tuqatih wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. Ya ayyuha an-nas taqu rabbakum alladhi khalaqakum min nafsin wahidah wa khalaqa minha zawjaha wa batha minhuma rijalan katheeran wa nisaa'a wattaqullaha alladhi tasaaluna bihi wal arham innallaha kana 'alaykum raqiba. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما فإن أحسن الحديث كلام الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is book 1, lesson 1. The Arabic, we start at page 10. Before we start, inshallah ta'ala, some advices. Firstly, our intention and ikhlas, sincerity. Our intention for studying this book or this particular subject should be to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to learn as much as you possibly can on the subject matter and then to practice it. And once we have reached a level of expertise in the subject matter, then we should have the niyyah of conveying this information to those who do not know it, and also to discuss it with our colleagues, fellow tulabul ilm, students of knowledge, so that it becomes second nature to us, and guide with it our family members. We should do this sincerely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is al-ikhlas. Actions will not be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is righteous actions will not be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until they fulfill true conditions. Condition number one is that the action is done solely for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second is al-mutaba'ah. That means that the action must be in accordance to the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If a person makes salah, for example, sincerely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but then he's lacking in that his salah is not in accordance to the salah of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that action of his, of making salah, will not be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because it opposes the way that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught his ummah to make salah. Now that can be an analogy for all other actions that a person does. All one's righteous actions should fulfill these two conditions, al-ikhlas, sincerity, and al-mutaba'ah, following the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also some tips or advices on how one should approach the lessons. You should have a notebook by your side when you attend to these lessons, with a pen or pencil, and write down from the lessons whatever benefits you have acquired. Make notes of that. If you'd like to write down the whole lesson, then you may do so as well. Sometimes we may discuss certain aspects from other sources, either the Quran or the Sunnah, or the sayings of the scholars, or the sayings of the Sahaba, with regard to specific information that is derived from the lesson. And these can be also noted down, as you will not find them in your course material, or you won't find them in a textbook. So you can record these down. And then you might have a question, which you can also record and ask, inshallah, and post. If you wish to post it, or if you wish to ask it, then you may do so, inshallah. If you look at the Arabic, page 10, you will find that the top left-hand corner of every topic, you have a little square there, and that square indicates the outcomes that a student would like to be made aware of at the end of any chapter. So that gives a student an understanding of what he's going to learn in any given chapter. And perhaps you may have a desirous outcome for yourself on a particular chapter, and that may not be achieved in terms of what's in the book. So then your notebook can be a place where you could record an outcome that you had hoped to achieve and you never achieve it, and then we could attend to that inshallah as well. In the opening of the group, we mentioned that we could have a once a month face-off where we could discuss issues that we attended to in the course or any chapter of the course, and that inshallah you'll decide and let me know when that can happen. Should it be a prefixed date or for every month or ad hoc basis? So we're starting with the first chapter, which is Haqiqatul Tawheed, the reality of Tawheed. The reality, Haqiqatun, at Tawheed means the oneness or the unity. So the reality of at Tawheed. If you go to the block on the top left corner, أريد أن أتعلم, I would like to learn or I would like to know. This is a student that says that I would like to know or I would like to learn. أولاً, firstly, تعريف التوحيد, the definition of Tawheed. That's number one. This is what the student would like to know, the definition of Tawheed. And it's important when it comes to definitions throughout the book, throughout the course material, that one starts to memorize these definitions. Memorize it in Arabic. If you can't, at least know it in English. You know, if somebody had to ask you, what is Tawheed? You're studying Tawheed. What is Tawheed? Then you would be able to explain it. And in fact, Tawheed also refers to unification. Uniting, and we say oneness, we say unity, unification, all of these things in Arabic means a tawheed. Now that's your lexical meaning or the meaning of the dictionary of the language, but then there is a technical terminology or technical meaning for the word tawheed, which we will attend to inshallah shortly. Secondly, ثانياً أريد أن أتعلم. Once again, I would like to know أهمية العقيدة الصحيحة والحاجة إليها. I would like to know the importance of correct beliefs or the correct creed. Now, Aqeedah is referred to as belief or it is referred to as creed. This is the fundamental beliefs that a Muslim should have. So what is the importance of the correct creed or the correct beliefs? ثالثاً أريد أن أتعلم. Thirdly, I would like to know أن الأصل في الناس التوحيد مع الأدلة, that the origin of mankind is Tawheed. I would like to know about that, and also مع الأدلة, with evidences. I would like to know with evidences that the origin of mankind is that he was on Tawheed. Mankind was on Tawheed. رابعاً, أريد أن أتعلم. I would like to know مصادر العقيدة الصحيحة مع الدليل. The sources of the correct beliefs with evidences. So, as we have noted here, the knowledge that the student wants to attain and wants to know must be backed up by evidences, especially those pertaining to the creed. And this is the way that a student of knowledge should go about in matters of his deen, that he practices his deen based on evidences. There is no blind following, there is no guesswork. But when you practice the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you must practice it on the basis that whatever you are doing is supported by either the Quran or a verse in the Quran or a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and lastly that is the way it was understood by the Sahaba, because they were the students of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and obviously their understanding is the correct understanding as they took their knowledge directly from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Haqiqatul Tawheed. Now this is the main topic that we are going to, the reality of Tawheed. Tarifut Tawheed wal Aqeedati. The definition of Tawheed and the definition of Aqeedah. What is the definition of Tawheed and what is the definition of Al-Aqeedah? At-Tawheed. Firstly, the author or authors are going to talk about At-Tawheed. Now, the authors are PhD holders, master's level holders. They are specialists in the subject of Al-Aqeedah, lecturing in the various universities in Saudi Arabia on this subject. They have prepared this manual especially for the Dawah organizations in Africa so that this book can be taught throughout Africa. So they have prepared it in this particular style, which is a very, very good style, and it appeals to the students of knowledge, and it's very simple as well. So this level is a preparatory level, and as we go further, gets more advanced. But Tawheed, he says, إِفْرَادُ اللَّهِ وَتَعَالَى بِالْإِبَادَةِ وَغَيْرِهَا مِمَّا يُخْتَصُ بِهِ تَعَالَى. It is to single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone with worship. So Tawheed is to single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone for worship. وَغَيْرِهَا, and other than worship. Other than worship. مِمَّا يُخْتَصُ بِهِ تَعَالَى, from those things which are specific to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here an example can be the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when it comes to worship, ibadah, it should be purely and only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When it comes to the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we should know that there is nothing from the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that shares in such names and attributes. The names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are specifically for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If one practices that, then one is on Tawheed. Now, an example of that is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that He is the Lord of the worlds. When you read the Surah Fatiha, we say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. All praises are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the worlds. So this is the Lordship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Lordship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is something that is unique to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is not shared by anyone. There is no other Lord besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Khaliq, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator. And there's nobody else who is Al-Khaliq. That is the attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the creator, He creates, and being Al-Khaliq is specific to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran says He created Adam alayhi salam with His two hands. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has two hands. This is an attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We acknowledge that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has two hands, but how are these two hands, or how are the two hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This information is not known to us and hasn't been given to us. It's not in the Quran, it's not in the Sunnah. But we acknowledge this attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we also know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the Quran, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a face. And we know this from the ayah, وَيَبْقَى وَجْهُ رَبِّكَ ذُو الْجَلَالِ وَالْإِكْرَامِ. وَجْهٌ is a face. So that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a face. This is an attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is specific to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We do not know how the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, but this is an attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, and so forth, we go on like that. So Tawheed means, firstly, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. He is the only one entitled to be worshipped. Worship cannot be given for other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Secondly, Tawheed is also a reference to the names and attributes and other qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is specific to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and such names, attributes, qualities are not shared with other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Secondly, Al-Aqeedatu. Ma yajibu al-imanu bihi min umuri al-ghaybi kal-imani billahi wa malaikatihi wa kutubihi wa rusulihi واليوم الآخر والقدر خيره وشره وما يتبع ذلك من أمور. Now, Aqeedah is that which is compulsory to have faith in from the matters of the unseen, like having faith in Allah, believing in Allah and His angels and His books and His messengers and the last day and the divine decree. It's good and it's bad. All of it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whatever is included in that from matters of belief. So that's the meaning of Aqeedah. Aqeedah is connected to the beliefs. This is something which is not seen, but which is contained in an individual, in a Muslim. And this is compulsory to have such beliefs. Believing in the Lordship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then believing in all those matters of the unseen, like the angels, the books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believing in the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the last day, and the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the divine foreordainment, if you would like to use that term. That everything that happens on the face of the earth, everything that happens in the universe, happens because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed that it happens, whether it is good or bad. We have two decrees. One is the universal decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the universal decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything that exists, everything that happens, it happens with the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The good, the bad, the malaika, the shayateen, the robber, the holy one, everything is created and decreed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And beneath that you have the legislated decree. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created sin. That is the universal decree. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed it. But in the legislated decree we find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited one from sinning. So the existence of sin is by the universal decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The prohibition from sinning is the legislated decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created alcohol. That is the universal decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the legislated decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, alcohol is forbidden. Now, the slave has a choice. He can choose to ignore the legislated decree and thereby partake in alcohol. But he cannot use the universal decree as an excuse for doing the wrong, because the wrong has been explained to him in the legislated decree, and that is what he should abide by. And like this, all other matters connected with the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Man has been given the choice. The slave has been given the choice. He can either do that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited and forbidden, or choose to abstain because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited that or any other particular act. So this is the first lesson, inshallah. We will stop there, and we just attended to the meaning of, or the definition of Tawheed, the definition of Aqeedah, and it is brief. It hasn't been elaborated upon, but as we go on, we will get a better understanding, inshallah ta'ala, when the examples come and the references have been made to the ayat and the ahadith, then this subject matter will be expanded, inshallah ta'ala. But for now, we need to know the definitions and try to memorize them, if possible. If not, if it cannot be memorized word for word in the Arabic, then you can read through the meanings in English and understand that. and memorize the English if you can as well. جزاكم الله خير وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت استغفرك وأتوب إليك فالسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته